Arriving any moment, and these dirty vagabond, it'll be a nuisance.
Well, they don't mean any harm, Mrs. White. They're just playing hide and seek.
Right, well, when the army arrives, they will all be gathered up and boxed back to their homes.
Oh, they are just little children, Mrs. White, not shoes.
Just as dirty. Now, go play outside or something.
But it's raining, Mrs. White.
I don't rightly care. I can't wait until they leave. But until then, they're your responsibility.
Yes, Mrs. White.
Now, chew.
Oh, this room has so much energy. The aura is electric. Please tell Dr. Black, I simply must have my sleeping quarters placed in here.
This is the foyer, Lady Lavender.
Oh, so it is.
Well, could you read my palm, Lady Lavender?
Will you stop dilly-dallying and take Lady Lavender's luggage up to the first floor?
No, no, I'd much prefer the top floor. It has a fabulous view of the gardens.
Yes, well, I'm sure that can be arranged, but there's something I'll be needing from you first.
Oh, I wonder what that might be. Let me see. Ah, it's a man that troubles you. Tall, dark, handsome. Is it a love potion that you're after, Mrs. White?
Don't be daft. No, what I'm in need of is more of your sleeping potion.
Having trouble sleeping now?
Not for me. As you know, Dr. Black has such troubles drifting off to sea.
Do we have to continue this charade, Mrs. White? We both know that you like to help Dr. Black drift off to sleep, so you can help yourself to his wallet.
He doesn't pay me enough. You know that. I'm simply helping myself to what I'm due.
He won't be paying you much if he marries Dame Daffodil.
How do you know about Daffodil, that malicious uppity snob?
I read palms, tarot cards, and I have my ever-powerful crystal ball. I know lots of things.
Hish posh.
Don't be dismissive, wife. If Black marries Daffodil, you'll be out of a job. Daffodil hates you, I can feel it.
Right, well, to be safe, I'll need 3 vials of your potion.
The price has gone up.
What?
The war has made it difficult for me to source my special herbs. £4 per vial. Leave the money in my room and I'll send you the potions.
How can I trust you?
How can I trust you? Oh, that's right. You need me. But remember to use no more than 3 drops per glass. Too much can put someone to sleep forever.
Why didn't you tell me this before? I gave him 4 drops last week.
Oh, silly me. I forgot. That Dr. Black must have a really strong constitution.
Right, well, you get me the vials, I'll get you the money.
Wait! I see darkness in your future.
Just the potions, please, Lady Lavender.
Alrighty, but remember no more than 3 drops. Toodaloo!
Of you.
Can we see her, please? Please, Mrs. White.
See who?
Miss Scarlet!
I am so sorry about this, Miss Scarlet. I'll have the servants take them away at once.
Oh, not to worry. They're my fans, after all.
Hogarth? Hogarth! Are you deaf, sir? No matter. Olive, Amber, go take these children away and give them a bath.
I never knew Dr. Black had children.
They're relocated.
Relocated from where?
London. You know the bombing of London.
I left England during the war. All that ugly business with the Germans. Far too stressful. I spent the last few years in California. It was such a dream. Isn't that right, Ruby? These are my personal assistants, Ruby and Jasper, my valet. I simply never go anywhere without my assistants.
I see. Well, I'll have Woody take your luggage up to your room.
Only Jasper touches Miss Scarlet's luggage.
Okay, then right this way.
Ugh, what a miserable old cow. Ruby, are you listening?
Oh, sorry, Miss Scarlet. I was just thinking about those children. Being away from their families is such a long time.
Save your sympathy for me. I'm on the brink of becoming a film star. And you know what that means, Ruby? I will be famous. More famous than I already am. I was the darling of the London stage before the war. Not that that matters now. Do you hear? What do I always say?
Film is where the real fame and money is.
Yes, now look around you, Ruby. What do you see? Staircase? No, silly. A mansion. And what does a mansion mean?
A large house?
You're simply hopeless, Ruby. A mansion means money, jewels, diamonds. And Dr. Black is the man who owns that mansion. So we must convince him.
Sorry, I was just wondering if those children were orphans.
We are talking about me, Ruby. Me, Miss Scarlet. Now, I must find a way to get Dr. Black to finance my film career. Do you understand, Ruby? Aren't you listening, Ruby? We went over this before. If I don't get the money from Black to continue my career, you will be out of a job. And you too, Jasper. We need the money. Got it?
Yes, Miss Scarlet.
I'm a star in the rising, Ruby. Do you all hear me? My time is coming. Just wait and see. I will be famous. Hollywood, here I come. The butcher, the baker, the grocer, the clerk are secretly unhappy men because the butcher, the baker, the grocer, the clerk get paid for what they do with no applause. They'd gladly bid their dreary jobs goodbye for anything theatrical. And why?
There's no business like show, business like no, business I know. Everything about it is appealing, everything that traffic will allow. Nowhere could you get that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra bow. There's no people like show.
To the horses. You know she hates me.
Yes, but she makes me laugh.
She makes me want to reach for a bucket.
Well, it's time I remarried Mrs. White. Beatrice has been gone for 2 years now. It's time to move on. Time for you to get back to work.
I'm helping the guests, isn't that right, Lady Lavender?
Of course, she's been most helpful.
Lady Lavender.
I'm so pleased you invited me here again. You know I love visiting your estate. So much fresh air. And the trees, oh, I do love the trees.
My garden is out of bounds for you, Lady Lavender.
But I am one with nature. Trees and plants are my tools that I heal the world with.
May I remind you that last year you destroyed all of my roses, and the year before that you uprooted all of my sage, and the year before—
I did it for my potions!
You know what I think about your potions, my dear? Mrs. White, make sure that Lady Lavender is indoors during her stay with us. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Dr. Black, wait! Your aura is very murky. Can I read your palm?
Again, Lady Lavendar.
The future is an ever-evolving essence. Every day, an action consists of new ripple effects.
No, I do not have time.
A quick reading, then. Oh, I see. Terrible, terrible. I see dark times ahead.
Lady Love.
Everything black. I think this weekend is causing you some stress. If you're not careful, something terrible will happen.
Now, let me read your poem, Lady Lavendar. Yes, I see trouble looming with the authorities, especially if you keep destroying my gardens.
Dr. Zack, I need my plants and herbs. People need my potions to plant them up.
Your potions are illegal and dangerous. Bogarth, please leave these ruins. Bogarth, fetch me my hunting jacket. Prepare the dogs.
Of course. Professor Plum is waiting for you in the library.
We'll get him out of there. He gets lost. Inform him that he'll be joining me for a spot of hunting.
Of course, sir.
And remember, Lady Lavendar, heed my warning.
And remember why more than 3 drops can be deadly.
Say what we like about the enemy. Men, at ease.
Please, wait here.
At attention. Private, I said at attention. We are to depart from these premises at exactly 1900 hours. And as we're dealing with children, this should be a simple mission. Seek and relocate. Any questions?
Oh, cheerio, Captain. I am the Colonel Mustard, at your service. What is your mission here, soldier?
Captain Brown, at your service. We're here to relocate the children.
I see. Well, as your superior, I shall be taking charge of this mission.
With all due respect, Colonel, I was assigned leadership of this mission.
I outrank you, officer, and now I'm in charge. I want you to gather up these children and return them to London by midday. Is that understood? They're in the way here.
Yes, sir.
There's one! Ah! Soldiers!
Oh, don't worry, children. These are our soldiers.
You there, gather up the children. We need to relocate them.
Well, they can't go now, because it's their afternoon snack time.
I beg your pardon, sir, but we have our orders.
Well, the children can't leave now. They're so hungry.
Well, Captain, what are you waiting for?
Apparently it's their snack time, sir. Afternoon snack time.
Come, children.
Are you using that as an excuse not to do your job? Do I have to command your troops for you? What kind of a man are you? Just do your job, soldier! What the hell is wrong with your privates?
Oh! Hello, gentlemen!
Ah, Miss Scarlet. Pleasure to make your acquaintance. I'm Colonel Mustard. At your service, ma'am.
Oh, pleased to make your acquaintance, sir. I'm so sorry if I'm distracting your men, sir.
Ah, that's Colonel Mustard.
Oh, Sir Colonel Mustard. I can't help being famous.
Ah, too true.
You there, soldier. What is your name?
Permission to speak, sir.
Permission granted.
Private Tony, ma'am.
Would you like an autograph?
Yes, please. Yes, please.
It's just not healthy for you to constantly sit and read, Plum. You need to get alive, meet a lady, settle down.
Well, now that you have mentioned it, there is someone I rather like, but it is still early days.
splendid. I'm sure you'll use your charm to woo her.
Well, that's the problem. I don't have charm.
Ah, nonsense. Ah, Scarlet. It's a pleasure to see you again. Your bracelet, I see.
Oh, a family heirloom, Dr. Black.
Colonel Mustard. I see your mustache is getting longer as always.
Ah, Dr. Black, as astute as ever.
Oh, God, please lead these fine soldiers to the kitchen for a refreshment.
Gentlemen, the kitchen is to your left.
Thank you, Dr. Black.
It's a pleasure.
Captain! Now listen here. I'm expecting you to succeed in your mission.
Yes, Colonel Mustard.
Mustard, this is my dear friend, Professor Plum.
Plum?
Mustard? Oh, and Hogarth, please lay out a selection of guns for Colonel Mustard. I'm right to assume you'll be joining us for a spot of hunting.
Hunting? Oh, jolly oh, I do love a good spot of hunting.
Shall we select our weapons, gentlemen? Follow me.
Oh, I brought my very own Winchester back. I never depart from it.
Really?
Saw me through lots of war action.
Dispatch a lot of Germans, did you?
Of course. I destroyed those Jennies right and proper.
Really now? Find that hard to believe.
What exactly are you implying?
Just my dry sense of humor, old chap. Don't look so worried. It's not as if you have something to hide now, is it? Let's get to your famous Winchester.
Dr. Black, I was wondering if I may have a word with you in private.
I'm off my daily hunt, unless you care to join us.
Thank you, but I'm not interested in killing any innocent creatures. But I really must speak with you before dinner.
No promises.
No promises? What a pompous bull! Oh, the nerve of that man! Maybe he should be lapping at my heels. My name should be on everyone's lips. Ruby, we must come up with a plan to seek Dr. Black in private. Have you any ideas? Jasper? Useless. Both of you. Simply useless!
Oh, just one moment, gentlemen. I'll meet you outside.
I don't trust that Colonel Mustard man.
Neither do I.
Then why invite him on a hunt? A hunt of all things!
Plum, you worry too much.
Do remember to take the safety latch off before you shoot, sir.
Ah, so that's what went wrong last time.
Oh, Uncle, please tell me it is not so.
Peach, not now.
So it is true.
Peach, I'm rather busy. Can we please discuss this later?
No, Uncle, I'm very firm on this. You must hear me out.
Now, young lady.
Look at my lip, Uncle. It's quivering. I'm in a lot of distress.
Dr. Plack, I'm sure our hunt can be postponed. Lady Peach seems rather distressed.
You know nothing of hunting, my dear friend. We cannot postpone. Peach, you have 1 minute of my time. No theatrics, mind you.
Oh, Uncle, I'm so upset that you've invited Monty Brunette here this weekend.
Why, he's your fiancé, my sweet.
He is not. I hate him.
Once you get to know him, you'll like him well enough. If that's all, let's go.
Oh, I cannot accept an arranged marriage, Uncle. I want to be able to choose my husband. Monty Brunette is disgusting. I can't marry him.
Oh, I'm afraid you will. I'm your guardian, and he's the man I've chosen for you. And you know the deal. Well, I've cut all of your money.
Why can't I choose?
And choose? And who would you choose? The one who's been tending to my horses? He's a servant and probably a thief. You are a lady. I know you had little fancy for him last summer. But I thought you outgrew that. He's a mere gypsy.
He's a prince.
A prince of the gypsies. That means nothing.
But I
don't incriminate yourself, my dear. Your love for the gypsies is fleeting. Just like the seasons, it'll pass.
No, you are wrong. He loves me, not him.
Peach, if I see you anywhere near Prince Azul, I'll banish him and his crazy family of gypsies off of my land. Do you understand?
Oh, Uncle, you have distressed me. Oh, I feel very faint.
Dr. Black, Lady Peach needs some assistance.
You really never knew anything about the ladies, did you, Plum? Oh, Garth, tend to my knees. Are you ready, Professor Plum? Our hunt awaits us.
Oh, what are you looking at? You always take his side.
You don't own me. I'm not just one of your many toys. You don't own me. Don't say I can't go with other boys. And don't tell me what to do.
doing?
I don't want to take a nap. I want to go fishing.
Yeah. After your nap, these soldiers will take you back home. We don't want to go home.
That will be impossible. We, the 21st Regiment, will be taking you home at approximately 1400 hours.
Oh, don't cry.
Yes, well, we will be reuniting you with your families.
Oh, things are going to have parents.
Well, we know how to handle difficult situations. I am a master of negotiation. Come here, little chappy.
I wouldn't do that if I were...
Oh, we must find a way to cheers him up. We must cheers him up.
Well, sweets do have a way of cheering up children.
Lollipop, lollipop, oh, lollipop.
None of Lavender's potions, Mrs. White. This bandage will suffice.
I told you that! That Colonel Mustard Man doesn't like you!
I don't like any of my guests, Plum. You always know a new powers likes a bit of antagonism. Besides, you're really harmless.
Oh, harmless, you say? Harmless, you say? From my vantage point, I saw Mustard! What pigeon my back buckled! He was aiming at you!
You always thought you knew better than me, Plum. Hogarth, get my valet to run a bath for me. I feel like a good soaking.
This is most distressing. I'll get some tea sent up.
Plum, why don't you go to the library and read a book? That always seems to cheer you up.
I'll get some tea sent up.
lady of the house party.
Oh, yes, yes, there are certainly noticeable changes.
Well, Hogarth, have you start prepare a warm bath for my lovely birds. And escort bird boy to my rooms, please.
The master has forbidden your birds, Miss Peacock.
My birds go everywhere with me, and always have. Oh, step aside, Hogarth. I shall do as I please. Bird boy, to my rooms. And remember, I want fresh water daily, and clean straw.
As you wish, madame.
Oh, and bring up some meat for Jajo and Delilah. My birds are on a specific diet.
Meat? But Dr. Black doesn't let any guests near.
Oh, never mind, I will do it myself. Oh, mother will take care of you, my darlings.
Woody, it seems the master has brought in a lot of dirt from his hunt. Clean it up.
Me?
Yes, you. That's what we hired you for.
But I'm training to be a valet.
You clean all of this up, or I'll tell the master you've been stealing from him.
Stealing from him? I haven't stolen a thing.
My word against yours. Now, have all the guests arrived yet?
No, but most of the ladies have, all except Dame Daffodil.
Dame Daffodil? What is she waiting on? To make a grand entrance? Who does she think she is, the queen? No. Oh, tell me the moment she arrives. I'd like to make her feel right welcome.
Yes, yes, Mrs. White. Right.
Welcome, Monsieur Brunette. Please, let me take your coat.
Oh, merci. Even in spring, England feels like winter. Have you prepared the room I requested?
Yes, next to Miss Peach.
Oh, fantastic. Oh, and does it have a fire going?
Yes. You will remember how well I take care of you when you marry.
Oh, how could I forget? I'll be a most gracious and fair lord of the manor. When Dr. Black is departed, of course. But I do have very high standards. I am French. At first, I think I would redecorate. Oh, mon dieu. We will need some proper food. How about I bring in my French pastry chef? Only the French know how to cook. And you there. Is there a gramophone in the building?
Well, there was one before the war, but ever since the lady...
I do not want to know your life story. Just, please, send it up to my room. I need to listen to some Mozart as I relax. And please, send some coffee up to my room. British tea is so boring.
Oui, oui.
Merci.
Ah, Mrs. White, top of the morning here.
It's long past noon.
Oh, so it is.
You haven't been hitting the bottle again, have you, Reverend?
Oh, dearly me, no, no. They're all just rumors. Don't you believe in rumors?
No, I don't, but I do believe my own eyes and nose.
Look, I really must have a word with Dr. Block. Very important.
I'm sure it is, but he's indisposed as of the moment.
Yes, but surely as the pastor of his parish, I take precedence over others.
Yes, right, because you're holy. But I'm afraid he's resting.
He's resting at this time of the day.
He's been shot.
Oh dear, is he all right?
Yes, he'll be fine. He'll be there to dinner.
Oh, well, if he's resting, perhaps I should do the same. Till dinner. Thank you, Miss White.
Yet delicate. Oh, and genuine.
Bird boy, go take my bird out for some fresh air. I need to find Dr. Black before dinner time. You there! I need the location of Dr. Black's whereabouts.
Well, he might be in his study.
Might be? Oh, what kind of a servant are you?
Well, I'm a footman.
Well, use your little feet to walk and find him.
But I have other duties to finish first.
Your duties are to serve the guests.
Yes, m'lady.
Oh, my bird can probably do a better job tracking a man down.
It's the other corridor. Third room. And take those flowers outside. They bring in bees. Can't get good staff these days.
You there, take my luggage to the room with the garden view.
As you wish, Dame Daphne.
When I am mistress here, things will change. First, I'll begin by removing this picture of Dr. Black's wife. Beatrice is long gone, and so is my dear Teddy. But we must soldier on. Now, bring me some tea.
Yes.
Some pure English tea, none of that foreign concoction. And fresh milk to my room. Are you listening?
Of course, m'lady.
And this room here needs something. It's so pastiche. When I am mistress, this room shall be redecorated to reflect my standing in society. And new curtains, yes, and some expensive furniture.
Hello, Dame Daffodil. I didn't hear you arrive, but I don't listen out for the devil.
And when I am mistress here, my servants will be carefully selected.
But you're not mistress yet.
Oh, but I will be, and then you'll be out of a job. You there, escort me.
Not if I have anything to do about it. Oh, what was that, Mrs. White?
Oh, Hogarth, you truly must stop sneaking around. Didn't you have work to be doing?
Oh, I don't know. Don't you?
Oh, Azor.
I miss you so much, my love.
Oh, Azor, everything is hopeless. Monk will never permit me to marry you. Never. He still insists that I marry Monk to Brunette.
Brunette? How do we even sure he's a man? That accent, I do not trust.
I shall be forced to marry him. And if you and I are seen together, Monk will expel you and all the gypsies from his land. Oh, what are we to do?
Let's alone.
What?
Alone means run away and get married.
I know what it means. But why?
I have a plan. You can come live with me and my family, yes? Come, Jinza, Zizi, Myra, come and meet my peach. Soon, she'll be your princess. And when I marry my peach, we'll make our home here.
And we will have an apartment in home.
But we're gypsies, we are not my five class.
Yeah,
no.
We must stay.
My brothers and sisters, let's not argue. Let's welcome my peach into our family.
Hey! Oh, you're going to love me.
Thank you.
Lizzie, bring back that furniture. If we are to live here, we cannot live in an empty house. Thank you. Thank you. No. Ah, my Peach. They love you. Almost as much as I do.
Oh, Azura, you're so romantic. But we must be practical. I love you, but I can't live as a gypsy. And we need money to survive. Lots of it. I can't live in anything less than a mansion. And if you loved me, you would want me to be happy, wouldn't you?
Then we must change your uncle's mind.
Oh, my uncle's quite stubborn. Last time I disobeyed him, he sent me to boarding school in America, and I still haven't lost this accent. If I push him too hard, he'll cut off my monthly allowance. Oh, well, if only he were to die soon. I'm set to inherit £2,000 a year.
That is a lot of money.
Oh, well, if only he were to die. Painlessly, of course. We could find a way to make sure he dies.
My love, I am a thief. But a murderer?
If you loved me, you would find a way. Someone's coming. Quick, hide.
He has finally here it is.
What do you do with my uncle's
pain? Get the Jesus out of me.
Are you allowed to take the Lord's name today, Reverend, while you open my uncle's letters?
Oh, no, you're mistaken. This is my letter.
Do you recognize his handwriting, Miss Peach?
Oh, it's my uncle's handwriting. What are you hiding, Reverend Green?
Don't be preposterous. I'm a man of God.
A man of God, you say?
Well, I mean, how did you gypsies know about God and religion, anyways?
We have a religion. Money is our religion.
Oh, and are you about to try and blackmail me now, are you?
I do not know. Are these things about you true? You've been a very bad boy.
Look, give me that. I'm surprised he can read.
Oh, I can do lots of things. You do seem to enjoy wine.
This letter's addressed to my uncle's lawyer. You are in a lot of trouble, Reverend Green.
I'm trying to destroy the evidence.
That's all lies. Lies, I'll tell you. I'll kindly ask you not to meddle in me affairs.
Then maybe we could make a deal.
Ugh, I do not make deals with the devil.
Poor man. Your uncle will have his hair on a chopping block. You see the way his eyes popped out of his head? Don't be preposterous. I am a man of God.
Oh, well, if only we could use his misfortune to our advantage.
Miss Peach, I did not realize you had such deviousness. You should have been born a gypsy.
Oh, I'm being practical. I'm thinking about our future.
Me too. I took the Reverend's wallet. He certainly has a lot of money in his wallet.
How are you?
I think you're misplaced. Well, 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 what do we have here? Miss Peach engaged to another man but embracing the gypsy? Don't say another word. Neither shall I. No, your uncle will never hear me speak poor of his dear little niece. I shall say anything, but neither shall either of you. I'll be taking that letter.
No.
And you thieving pig, give me my wallet.
Oh, you know what you have to do, Azur. That's the dinner bell. If you're a man, you'll know what to do.
Men, it's time to complete our mission. Seek and relocate. Go!
Oh!
outmaneuvered again. We can't allow Colonel Mustard to think that we've failed. We must come up with another tactic.
Captain Brown, there will be a light supper for you and your regiment to harbor.
Thank you, Hogarth. Men, fall out! One, two!
It's a wonder we even won the war. Mrs. White, you haven't been near the kitchen, have you?
What's that supposed to mean, Hogarth?
Not tampering with any of the food, are you, madame?
You shouldn't make such accusations.
Welcome to Black-worth Manor. Joining us for dinner tonight are Colonel Mustard of the 5th Regiment, Professor Clark,
wonderful before the war. I had money, comfort, and security.
Yes, times have changed.
What is that smell?
A cologne, a present from a friend. Let me introduce you to my guests.
Oh, you no, thank you. They all look rather unique.
Yes, just like you, they all want something from me.
But I only want your happiness.
Course.
And mine. So when we marry, only those of impeccable upbringing will be allowed to our home.
You will not be selecting my guests.
If you imagine I'm going to let these creatures into my home, perhaps we may have to rethink our arrangement.
The way I see it, Dame Daffodil, you need me particularly to pay all of your huge war debts. When I have, I'll have you sign your whole estate to me.
But that's blackmail.
That's business.
Oh, Dr. Black, you have been avoiding me all night, and I really need to talk to you about my precious birds.
Your birds? The ones that have been breeding on my land again?
Oh, I can't control their mating habits, Dr. Black.
Well, I can.
You wouldn't dare.
I warned you about your birds. They're aggravating my dogs and destroying my trees. They must leave.
But what about the bird sanctuary? Oh, if you fund that, they will breed...
No, out of the question. No sanctuary, no birds.
We had a deal. What kind of a man are you to break a deal with a lady?
An impatient one you are. If you do not remove your birds at once, I would get Colonel Mustard to shoot him with his famous Winchester. Good evening, madam.
Refreshments.
Oh, enough of that man. Someone just needs to put him in this place.
His aura is very dark. I fear something will happen. Something sudden and painful.
That's a good idea.
Pate? Meat! Oh, how terrible! I can sense how that poor cow died!
Dr. Black, be sure to misunderstand if you ask forgiveness. There's so many things you can learn from the Gospels.
It's not Sunday Mass, Reverend. I don't want to hear your preaching.
Well, yes, I also must talk about something else. You see, me parish has fallen into a bit of disrepair, and, well...
I fund the church quite handsomely. You cannot manage your own church affairs. Perhaps I need to find a better priest.
Oh, no, that won't be necessary. Not at all.
Well, I need to manage my affairs.
Oh, won't the devil take him?
Ah, Dr. Black, thank you very much for inviting me. You had a change of heart?
No. I just want to keep you where I can see you. But if I see you anywhere near my niece, however, I'll have your crazy family thrown off my land, I'll have you drawn and quartered, understood?
Yes, Dr. Black, your instructions are very clear. My gypsies are forever grateful for your patronage. Somebody needs to put that man in his place.
A drink for you, sir?
When we are married, I will take you to see the Apple Tower. Have you been there, my dear?
No, I've spent most of my life in America.
That is so boring. France is so full of charm and life. We will take a cruise down the French Riviera. The war, it has ruined some parts, but France will always remain beautiful at its own.
It's just like you, my dear.
Can I ask you something, Monsieur Brunet?
Oh, anything, my dear.
Why do you want to marry me? I'm not stupid, so please tell me the truth.
Well, it's because I promised your uncle.
What does my uncle have over you to force you to marry me?
That I cannot tell you, but I always keep my promises. Don't worry, though. Nobody lives forever. And when your uncle passes, you and I will inherit a lot of money.
Yes. But why can't you fund my career anymore?
Not this again. I've told you before.
But what will I do?
Come now, Miss Scarlet. You have talent and plenty of willing benefactors.
But I could be a Hollywood film star.
Yes. Just find another hapless fool who'll gladly pay for all of your exorbitant bills.
But I need the money. I really must have the money. Damn! Kill that man. Ruby, Jasper, we must do something.
Oh, dear Daffodil, it's just so wonderful to see you again.
Oh, Professor Plum, I hardly recognize you without your beard.
Well, I thought I would, forgot what I was going to say.
Oh, still get tongue-tied, I see. Beatrice tried so hard to eradicate your shyness.
Oh, yes, Beatrice was ever so patient.
Oh, yes, how I miss her.
Yes, she was such a lovely lady, and she was so sweet and so gentle, and she had that funny little laugh of hers.
Yes, you knew her well.
Well, yes, we were barely friends growing up a long time ago. But what I'm trying to say is I'm more interested in you and what you've been up to since the last time. What I'm really trying to say is I had a good time at the luncheon last weekend.
Ah, Dame Daffodil. Dr. Black tells me that you have a spot of wild rabbits on your land. I can fix your problem.
Oh, yes. Please, do come hunting and get rid of all those damn pests.
With his aim, he might shoot at your horses.
It was an accident.
I saw you aim, Colonel Mustard.
Not worth it, all of this fuss, gentlemen. Can't we be civilized at least until tomorrow? Colonel Mustard, care for some schnapps?
Actually, I love German drinks.
I actually don't drink.
Right, of course.
Hey. I see you met my lovely neighbor. Giving me the cold shoulder, are we? Dame Daffodil, will you please accompany Colonel Mustard and show him all of the new paintings I've had commissioned?
I don't like to be ordered around.
Oh, she's such a lovely lady. Smart, intelligent, aristocratic.
And very feisty.
Yes, and a widow with a very large estate. She will make someone a very lucky man.
Well, that's why I've chosen to marry her.
You, what?
Are you okay, old boy?
Oh, I'm fine. Just fine.
Well, I'm ready to marry again.
And you sure she will have you?
Yes, Plum, she needs me. Just like you, my dear friend, and everyone else here.
Lady Lavender, is this dirt underneath your fingernails? Have you been through my garden again?
You must let me explain. You must understand how important my herbs are. They heal. They provide important service for humanity.
I'll have all of my servants uproot the whole patch of the indigo night's flower.
You, sir, are despicable.
Yes, one of my better qualities.
Do you know how important that flower is to me?
Plum, tell me about this indigo night flower. Indigo night flower, also known as Selene Popperis, a flower whose sweet-scented petals are often used to calm nerves, but when combined with other substances, can cause deep sleep or even death.
Are you making accusations, Dr. Black? I need that flower for my apothecary business.
That is a dangerous flower, and you are a dangerous woman, Lady Lavender.
Oh, I can become dangerous, right? Very dangerous. I can conjure spirits and summon the wind. And I can predict your death. You, Dr. Black, will never see the light of day again. Make way.
Leaving already, Lady Lavender?
Don't be daft, old man. I haven't had my dinner yet.
So that's what a fruitcake looks like.
Yes. She's quite an original painting, but strangely enough, some of her predictions have come true. No matter. Come now, my dear friend. This party needs cheering up. Everyone, shall we have a dance?
Starts to play. flower bending in the breeze.
Please prepare them now.
They cannot possibly leave now. It is their bedtime.
It's 1800, madam.
You know nothing of children, soldier. Children are in bed late at 6:30. It is their bedtime. See how sleepy they all are?
Tomorrow. They will be ready tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow!
We'll be here at first light.
Captain, I've prepared a room for you and your regiment in the attic.
Thank you, Ogarth. Men, about face. March!
Good night, ragamuffins.
Children still doing up. They've been very loud and been a nuisance to the guests downstairs. Put them to bed at once.
You are Mrs. White. Bedtime. Now.
I don't want to go to sleep. I want to stay for tea.
Sing us a song, Woody.
Sounds like they are all having fun in the ballroom, but it is bedtime for all of you.
Yes, and while you are sleeping, the Sandman will come and bring you sweet dreams.
Who's the Sandman?
Well, he's the dream maker. What do you dream of, Olive?
Oh, only one thing. I want him tall, dark and handsome, just like Dr. Black.
Well, I'm a huge fan of Miss Scarlet. How I would love to twirl her around the dance floor, hold her in my arms, show her my best dance moves, And she would only have eyes for me.
Oh, what I'd give to go to a ball. I'd be the belle of the ball and dance with a mysterious rich lord.
Ha ha ha!
Dr. Black is dead!
I saw Mr. Williamson's pilot while cleaning his sword.
His peach still got left for his money.
I bet that would be Lady Lavender
poisoning
the lounge.
I saw Princess O with the rope at the hall.
I don't trust that Dame Deftel. She's up to something.
Yes. Well, maybe. It was Graham with his dagger in the library.
Oh, Miss Scarlet, it's a billiard room with a candelabra.
It could have been. Miss Peacock with the wrench in the hall.
Master, with the gun in the library.
Miss White with the lead pipe in the kitchen.
Professor Plum was in Robin's dining room.
All the crimes I've known, this one's lonesome. But Dr. Black died all in his lonesome. And when the guests came inside, it was dark as night, and this horrible crime came to me. They were all very sneaky, I'll admit you. Friendly expressions all to convince you. So I cracked my brain, hoping to explain all the clues I hope to see. Who is to blame? What is their game? Who is to blame? What's their plan? Who is to blame? What do they gain? And now poor Dr. Black is a very dead man. He could be Scarlet.
Ladies, enough!
Gray is here.
Inspector Gray?
Yes, the Inspector Gray.
You're looking suspicious. Show me your fingerprints. Take off your shoes. I'm gonna get so many fingerprints. I might make them take their pants off. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Detective Inspector Gray of Scotland Yard. And yes, I'm Scottish.
Don't you mean formerly of Scotland Yard?
Oh, Colonel Mustard! I'm not surprised to see you here gathered around this motley crew of nefarious wrongdoers. You are all guilty in my eyes. You are all suspects until I say so.
Suspects?
That's right. And as Mustard here said, I'm retired. After a long and illustrious career, I've been put to pasture. But don't let my retirement cloud your judgment. I am just as meticulous and astute as I was at the beginning of my career. I will smell you the murderer in less than 1 hour. And just to make sure, I've brought with me my best three trained detectives.
I must feel what the body is feeling.
Oh, almost tripped there. Oh.
Well, actually, I lost my best men during the war. Get me the things!
Oh, bloody hell, they're just as incompetent and stupid as you are.
Oh, what's the matter, Mustard? You afraid I might discover the truth about how you killed it?
You are a complete idiot, just like them.
No, no. Wherever I am, I'm in charge. I'm the boss. I'm the boss, I'm the king, I'm in charge, and I'll begin by telling everybody what to do. I'm the ruler of the game. No, you can't. Yes, you can. I'll decide, cause I'm the boss, that's right, I am. No one seems to notice, but now that I'm in charge, I'll decide on all decisions and make all the laws. I'm the ruler of the game. No, you can't. Yes, you can. I'll decide, cause I'm the boss, that's right, I am. It's so hard to understand why I should be in charge. Sophistication, intelligence, and yes, of course, I am quite smart. I'm the boss, I'm the king, I'm in charge, and I'll begin by finding everyone on the course. Is that cologne? That's expensive.
I'm French? Well, this is going to be easy.
Can you determine the cause of death?
Not yet, but I can determine the time of death.
Oh, he's brilliant, ain't he?
You see, when the deceased was murdered, he fell and landed on his watch at 1:03.
Oh, my uncle's watch was faulty. He held onto it for sentimental reasons.
All right, just give up, Gray. You've got nothing. Absolutely diddly squat.
That's not true. We have one important piece of evidence.
What?
The body. His body would reveal exactly how he was murdered. Now for the first clue, the shoe print on his face. Looks quite fresh. Let's find out who it belongs to.
Black Forest, my favorite. Oh, Arthur's almost here, Inspector the Detector.
All right, well, in the meantime, we'll do some further examination. Let's take his clothes off, boys. Jesus, boys. This is a work site. We've got a job to do.
Not again.
I don't want you all crying or whimpering. We're going on a little journey.
Just what the hell do you think you're still doing here, Captain? What are the children still doing here?
They were not ready yesterday. We're relocating them this morning.
Oh, what a colossal boulder. You won't be able to take them now.
What now? They have to go fishing, paint their cubby house, have another nap, bake some muffins. What else will delay their departure?
What kind of a soldier are you? One that can't sense danger? There's been a murder here, you fool. A murder most foul.
A murder?
Yes, my dear friend Dr. Black was murdered last night.
Come, children, we will put your luggage back.
Right, lads. It's time for you to help uphold the law. Make sure none of the suspects leave the room until we conclude our investigation. Keep a close eye on them. All right. Who wants to go first?
Men, secure the premises.
Nobody. As expected. I'll start with the servants in the kitchen. Plus, I'm hungry. I haven't had breakfast yet.
Breakfast is the most important part of the day, sir.
Oh, I know, but I was busy looking for my suit.
Oh, great, it's definitely your colour, sir.
Oh, what do we do now in this miserable place? I can repose!
I know, we need some entertainment.
I am an actress, not a circus performer. But I would never give up the opportunity to show off my talent. Servants, soldiers, prepare the room. Out of my way. Yes, get rid of that rug. Come on. Jasper, music.
Hello,
here?
Dr. Black often has tea.
Valerian and lavender and something else. Something strong. Strong enough like a horse. It'll help me sleep later.
Where were you at 12 midnight?
Well, I was in the tent in the bath.
What were you doing in the bath?
What do you think?
Wait, so why do you need a rope?
You like to wear a cologne? But it's you.
Oh, please, I am French.
We find a sword in your room. Care to explain?
I was practicing my fencing.
Yeah? Do you like practicing?
On people?
Only on stupid people.
You, stay in the kitchen. I'm a servant. I wake in the kitchen. Yeah, at 1 a.m. I was hungry. Yeah? Me too.
We find a wrench in your room. Care to explain?
Miss Peacock told me to use on the bird cages.
Wait!
To make sure that the birds don't get out.
Or to make sure they do get out.
What do you put in this cake?
Sugar!
Uh-huh, and this knife. It has your fingerprints all over it.
Why, I'm the cook, aren't I?
A likely story. I'll have to examine this cake further.
Where'd you kill Dr. Black?
I never met the man.
So why'd you want to kill him?
I didn't.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Do you have proof? Yes,
what?
Did you kill him?
I didn't. Yeah.
So how'd you do it?
Yeah, how?
I didn't kill him, but I might kill one of you.
You're one of the head servants here.
Well, what kind of question is that?
Did you see anything suspicious last night?
Well, in what way?
Did any of the guests act strange?
Well, yes.
Who?
All of them!
Oh, it's sore.
How are you feeling?
So happy! Once this will is run, we will be rich! No, sir, we need to get our stories straight.
Stories?
Let's say we were together. No, that would be improper. Well, I was in the bath. And you?
I went back to my gypsy camp after dinner.
Ole pupushe arriba. Ole pupushe arriba. Oh, Miss Peach. I would like to extend my condolences.
Thank you. He'll be sorely missed.
Yes, well, at least he left you well taken care of.
Yes, he was very thoughtful.
The mansion and all of his money. You are a lucky girl.
Are you implying anything, sir?
Not at all, my dear. You see, he left me well taken care of as well. If you look closely at the will, you, my dear, only get the inheritance if you marry me. So I'm grateful he's deceased. I get the girl and the money.
Aha! You killed Dr. Black!
I did not!
You have a motive. You want the girl and the money.
Yes, so do you. And we all know that gypsies can't be trusted.
Frenchmen can't be trusted. What did your people do during the war?
Oh, how dare you!
I dare.
That's it!
Tell me, sorry, you climb off.
On guard! Many people have fallen to my sword.
Are you sure it's because of your garlic breath? Your father must have been disgusted when he first laid eyes on you.
At least mine isn't my uncle.
Croissants!
Croissants!
It's all a Frenchman. I have the high ground.
Make the most of it. It is the last time you'll ever be taller than me. Cannot defeat me. I am royalty.
You probably stole that title just as you stole everything else.
Yeah, get up, get up, get up.
For heaven's sake, stop it. You're embarrassing me.
Anne, engaged couple. I want to go over your alibis. Where were you at 1:03 this morning?
Oh, well, we were together. I know it is improper, but I am French.
You Frenchies, you. Never quite trustworthy.
I beg your pardon?
Oh, with the ladies, of course. I'm not suggesting that you're the murderer, per se, unless you're confessing. Lads, get his fingerprints and his shoe print. Now, Miss Peach.
You can't sweet talk your way out of trouble that easily.
Well, why am I in trouble? I didn't kill him.
That's what you say. I say it's always the niece. Or is it always the butler? No offence, Hogarth.
None taken.
Now that I've conducted all the preliminary investigation, and I've spoken to all witnesses and suspects, I can... Actually, not everyone it seems. Captain, have your soldiers bring the children?
The children, sir?
Yes, they may be key witnesses, or even suspects. And you three, scour the place for anything suspicious.
Men, round them up.
Sorry, ma'am, I'm off.
All right, soldiers, conduct a thorough search of these children.
Oh.
Yes, that's right. They may be hiding key evidence, perhaps even the murder weapon. Search!
Great.
Detective Inspector Gray.
The children! Not criminals! Men, stop!
How do you know? Look, weapons! Continue, men!
They were asleep at 1800 hours. Men, stop!
How do you know? They may have snuck out. Continue, men!
We have plenty of witnesses. Men, stop! I'm your commanding officer. They only left their room for, a pee-pee!
I said content!
They are innocent! Men!
Inspector Detector! I found this gypsy sneaking around!
I was not sneaking. I work here. But I'm Prince Azur.
Prince that has to work. Something just doesn't add up. Put him in the lineup. And now,
pleasure.
Let's go for what we have so far. Lads, let's bring in the buddy. Alright, what do we have here? Small cuts and lesions all over the body. A lump on his head. A bullet wound. Frothing at the mouth. Blue lips. And a shoe print on his face. But he missed, and then they pecked him to death.
Mrs. Peacock!
That's preposterous. They only eat cooked meat. Besides, we all know that it was Mustard who killed him. It was his gun that was fired.
Colonel Mustard!
Yes, you killed him. You can't try to kill him during a hunting trip. You didn't want anyone finding out. You were a Nazi sympathizer.
Okay, that was before the war. And yes, obviously, I didn't want anyone to know. But I didn't kill him. You probably killed him for all we know. You were the one closest to him.
Professor Plum!
It's ridiculous. He was my best friend, and he was very good to me. We only disagreed about poetry. Poetry of all things.
Well, according to Mrs. White, she heard screaming coming from his room, and then all the way to the study. Can you identify the voices, Mrs. White?
Yes, as you said, I did hear screaming, so I went to investigate. And when I did, I saw Miss Scarlet standing over the master's body, holding a bloody candelabra in her hand.
Miss Scarlet!
Huh.
That explains the lump on his head, sir.
Must have died of a brain hemorrhage. Well, 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 Miss Scarlet, let me tell you how you did it. You went to his room after party, then you followed him to the library. You tried to convince Dr. Black to give you money, and when he refused, you hit him over the head with a candelabra and killed him! Then you pulled off your staff to help you dispose of the body in the parlour. First, you helped yourself to his wallet. And then you tried to throw his body out the window, but you heard someone coming, so you left the body where it was and ran away. Your man here sort of ran into the wall as a decoy. Isn't that right, Miss Scarlet?
No, you have it all wrong. Dr. Black asked me to meet him in the library. We did argue, but he agreed to give me a small sum. The lightsman had and I tried to grab the candelabra in the dark and accidentally hit him over the head with it. I called in my staff to help revive him by the window in the parlour. We heard the gunshot and left. As for his wallet, Mrs. White has been stealing money from him for years. Just ask his staff, drugging him to sleep and helping herself to his wallet.
Mrs. White!
Sleeping potion, you see. That explains a frothing lips.
No, that's preposterous. Okay, I may be a thief, but I am no murderer. Besides, he was a stingy old pig. We all hated him. Especially his niece and her lover, the Gypsy.
Yes, sir!
We did not kill him. I went back to my family after dinner. Mrs. Peach was having a bath.
Ah, now it makes sense. You killed your uncle so you could get the inheritance and be with your lover. You played me false, mademoiselle.
Oh, I didn't kill him. You did. You forced my uncle to change his will so that I had to marry you to get my inheritance.
You ruthless killer. You probably killed him with your fancy French sword.
That explains all the stab wounds on Black's body.
I would never stoop so low as to murder a man in cold blood. I am French. How dare you besmirch my character?
No, this is all very entertaining.
Yes, I do believe we are getting warmer. For I found this in the Reverend Green's coat.
Well, let's have a little look. See here we go.
Don't do that.
So it was you, Reverend Green. Non-honest man of God. Dr. Black knew about your little drinking problem, and you helping yourself to the church money!
Don't be preposterous! I'm but a man of God!
I saw you arguing with the master in the staircase!
Ah, but that's circumstantial, Mrs. White. We all bond with him. The Lord sees everything!
Dr. Knife. Green!
Oh, no, that's Dr. Knife! It's just a letter opener!
Maybe that explains all the stab wounds on Black's body!
Look, I may have made any mistakes, but I didn't kill the man!
Some of us threatened to kill him in front of everybody. You predicted his death because you planned it. Isn't that so, Lady Lavender? He destroyed your potions, missus, so you killed him.
Lady Lavender?
Potions, you say? That explains the blue lips. Symptomatic of poisoning.
I didn't kill him. I wasn't anywhere near him after dinner, was I, Mrs. White?
Oh, how could you, Lady Lavender?
Oh, shut up, White! I was trying to save my indigo night flowers. I was collecting bagfuls. Anyway, I can read palms.
She's a fraud. Only gypsies know how to read palms.
But I have a gift, a real talent. Oh, wait! I will consult my crystal ball. Move! Oh, I see. The murderer was... Dame Daffodil!
Dame Daffodil?
I beg your pardon. I was to marry Dr. Black.
Can you shoot a shotgun, madam?
No, of course not.
Could be her inspective detector. Whoever tried to kill him shot him but missed. We found a bullet in the walls.
What? Why would I kill him? We were to marry.
I mean, you did hate him. He was going to steal all of your estate.
Yeah. Well, maybe she killed him with this lead pipe that I found in the conservatory.
Yes, you changed your mind and killed him to be free for Plum!
Is that true?
No!
Oh, why would it be true? Why would anyone prefer me to Dr. Black?
Yes, Dr. Black and I had a falling out in the parlour, but I used the pipe to open the stuck windows to shoo away all those dreadful bees. Then Dr. Black said he was feeling ill, so I gave him his tea and then went upstairs. Then I heard the gunshot.
Well, I think I've got it now! The murderer found him in the library and poisoned him first, followed him to the kitchen, tried to shoot him but missed, then followed him and tried to strangle him with a rope in the study, or maybe try to suffocate him in the dining room, then bash him on the head with a lead pipe in the conservatory, drag him to the billiard room and try to stab him or even bite him. Finally, drag him to the window on the parlor to throw him out, but was interrupted by a noise that left the body where it was and ran away. Oh, I think I know the answer.
Who is it?
The murderer. Ace!
Mustard, you killed him!
Me? No, it was Peacock with a bird!
Oh, it was Dame Daffodil, the Black Widow!
No, it was that thief wife, she poisoned him!
No, it was the crazy one, Lady Lavender!
It was Scarlet, she needed the money!
Ah, it was Reverend Green, he had the most to hide!
No, it was Peach and the Gypsy, they wanted his money the most!
So then Monsieur Brunette, you planned all of this?
Sir, you insult me again! Are you ready, Azura?
Get out of here.
Mom? Yeah. Well, all right, fellas. Let's go.
It's been getting so hard listening to the things they say to me. I'd like to tell you everything I see.
Must be mad in the black, as a matter of fact, his eyes are red as the sun. And Scarlet and Gordon and Gordon and Gordon, she thinks she's the innocent one. Oh, yeah, it was like lightning. Everybody was fighting, and the music was soothing, and they all sat moving. Learning nothing's all I ever do. I softly call you home, then white appears is something strange to you. And the Gypsy in the back is ready to crack. He punches Brunette in the thigh, and Peach in the corner is the very best corner. She kills you with a wink of her eye. Oh yeah, it was electric, so frankly hectic. And yes, I'm leaving. I stop breathing!
These red marks are in fact stings.
Yes, take marks of cuts after all.
You're absolutely right, Inspector.
I am.
He got an anaphylactic shock and died.
What?
The bee stings.
Ah, I think I've got it now. Dr. Black is allergic to bees, and the bees are attracted to the flowers. Dr. Black was weakened by the poison in his tea, and the bees were aggravated by the cologne. They stung Dr. Black and he died! Death by an allergic reaction! Gosh, I'm brilliant! I'm amazing!
Yeah.
Bees as murder weapons? Fantastic. We need to find out who brought these flowers!
Rusty!
Find this Rusty, this mastermind of evil, this executioner of cruelty, this creator of torture, this bringer of destruction. Oh, he's probably sneaking around like an animal. We'll get our best dogs and then we'll find him, and when we do...
Oh! I'm Rusty.
Oh, you know you can get away with it, Rusty. Way to do it, Rusty, way! Way to get back so much!
I don't care, Dr. Black!
So why'd you bring him flowers?
Yeah, you like him in a special way.
Huh? Yeah. And the guns, we got you room!
No, Rusty!
Okay. Way, lad, way! Rusty, way!
I can't do it! I just saw some toad!
Oh, likely story. Cuff him!
Oh, Beatrice! Move! Boaretto, you damaged it!
Oh, she's a looker, ain't she?
For your information, she was more than a looker. She was the most wonderful and caring woman I have ever met. And she helped me with my stutter too!
Wait just a minute. You mean to tell me that you were in love with Dr. Black's wife?
What was that, Rusty?
Tristan told me Dr. Black needed curing up after his wife died. He said he loved these flowers and to put them in every room. Plus, you paid me £10.
Professor Black!
Yes, I killed him! I hated him! He was so arrogant! First he took Beatrice to me, and then he was planning on having Dan, Dumbledore too! You should have been mine! All I have is books! What can a man do with just books? And that, Dr. Black, he had it all! A man can't have it all!
Here and is like right here.
Well, actually, we don't need him. We solved the crime in under 1 hour. I told you I was brilliant. I'm amazing. I'm delicious.
The clown is to blame. The one who does it aim. The man born off the back is a very dead
It is true what they say, choose your friends wisely. Even though Plum is guilty, I'm not so sure the other guests were totally innocent. Now please, if you'll excuse me, I have to collect some books for Professor Plum. He'll need them where he's going.
It's so weird, I really thought it was Scarlet in that candle.
I thought it was Mustard with the gun.
Yeah, but who poisoned his tea and poured him that cologne?
Yeah,
a lump on his head.